So very good morning to everyone once again. In the previous few classes, we have discussed sampling and quantization topics under module 4. Module 5 is also the extension of sampling and quantization concepts. In the module 4, we had mainly focused our attention on sampling and related concepts. Now we shall shift our attention to quantization and their application in the digital communication, namely in the modulation schemes such as pulse code modulation, delta modulation, and so on. Okay, so the contents of module 5 are quantization, random process, pulse code modulation, delta modulation, and some of the practical applications, okay, of delta modulation. So as you all know, I've been telling you from many classes, we are living in a digital world where everything is digitized. We are connected via various internet nodes. We are transforming our security, be it biometric or iris mechanisms, to digital platforms for better reliability and accuracy. And this trend will continue for many years to come. Even when we talk about transmission of electromagnetic waves, instead of transmitting the electromagnetic waves in the form of analog signals, we are converting that into digital signals and transmitting it over long distance. And even our DNA data, all these things are compressed and stored in a digital computer so that it can be easily processed and further analysis and decision making can be taken. Okay, so that's the impact of digital world. So in this scenario, we take the data from the physical world or the natural world using sensors. So sensors such as temperature sensor, humidity sensor, etc. These sensors capture the analog signal or the physical quantities, and then the same is converted into digital platform before it is processed using a computer. So in order to do this, what we do is we use say a transducer, for example mic in this case. When a human being is talking, the sound wave is produced, which is analog in nature. That is, it is its amplitude is varying with respect to time. This mic will capture the sound signal and it is given to the input of ADC. The output of this mic is a analog signal. The analog to digital converter will convert this analog signal to digital platform, and then it is stored or processed using a computer. And then this computer can then transform this digital data to analog data using digital to analog converter, and the same can be heard over a loudspeaker, right? So if we look at the evolution of digital transmission, each and every digital transmission mechanism involves usage of analog to digital converter, because almost all the original data or the information generated is analog in nature. So we have to transform these analog signals to a digital platform. So we have to use analog to digital converter, right? And when we talk about the transformation of analog to digital platform, it is also it has also taken place in the field of communication. In earlier days, we had analog terrestrial transmission of signals. You can see the analog signals are transmitted directly, and the antenna will intercept it, and then it is received over the television. Now in the digital terrestrial transmission, you can see analog to digital converter board is used, which will transform this signal into digital, and it is transmitted over long distance. The antenna will capture this digital signal, and then the decoder or the set of box in the home will convert this into analog, and it can be viewed over television. Okay, so typically this is what you see in your home. So the signal that you are going to receive, or your antenna is going to receive, will be digital in nature. When that is given to the converter box or the set of box, it is transformed into analog, and then you'll be able to enjoy your television, okay, or movie or whatever picture on the television. Why should we digitize analog data? Because there are many advantages when we convert analog signal to digital signal. It is less immune to noise. You can club video, audio, and data together. You can do multiplexing. It is less sensitive to physical variations such as vibration, temperature. It is easier to characterize. Hardware design is easier, etc. And when we talk about analog to digital conversion, we also should talk about the concepts such as sampling and quantization. So in the previous module, our focus was largely on sampling, wherein we transformed our analog signal to a sampled signal by using Nyquist rate or sampling theorem or sampling frequency, that is FS should be greater than or equal to 2FM. Now, in this module, our focus will be on quantization. What is quantization? What is the need for quantization? And what are the types of quantization? And what is quantization error? And what are the expressions or the equations associated with quantization? And where is quantization used in practical scenario? Then after quantization, we can also perform another level of encoding. Already, the quantization output will produce digital output. If you want to add one more level of encoding, you can perform encoding, okay, for this binary data, right? Now, first, let us understand what is quantizer. Quantizer is a device that changes the sampled input into quantized signal that has some predetermined fixed voltage levels. And this level depends on the encoder, whether you are using 2-bit encoder, 3-bit encoder, and so on. Larger the bit size, lesser will be the quantization error, but complexity and cost increases if you increase the bit size. So quantization is performed on the analog signal, and it is one of the most important steps in analog to digital conversion. By the process of quantization, you are basically converting the continuous amplitude signal to discrete amplitude signal. So this is the quantization process. All of you please pay attention and listen carefully. The analog signal is first sampled like this, and we call this as sampled signal. After this, the sampled signal is converted into discrete signal, and that is referred to as quantized signal. So analog signal is having continuous time. So time is continuous, amplitude is also continuous in the analog signal. In the sampled signal, the time is discrete, but the amplitude is continuous. But in the discrete signal, time is discrete and the amplitude is also discrete. Okay, so this is about analog signal, sampled signal, and quantized signal. Okay, and there can be two types of quantizers: uniform quantizer and non-uniform quantizer. We'll discuss more about this in the topics to come. But at this point of time, I just want you to know the difference between uniform quantizer and non-uniform quantizer. If you look closely at the diagram of uniform quantizer, you can see the steps or the staircase are all of uniform size, uniform step size, isn't it? Each step is of same size. If I say the step size as say delta, all the step size are same. That is uniform quantizer. In uniform quantizer, all the step size is same. But in non-uniform quantizer, you can see the step size is not same, it is varying. So in non-uniform quantizer, the step size or delta is not same, it is varying. In practical applications, the uniform quantizer is going to give lesser accuracy, but it is available at low cost. But non-uniform quantizer will give better accuracy, but the cost and complexity increases if we go for non-uniform quantizer. Okay, uniform quantizer has fixed step size. It gives less accuracy, but the design and implementation is easier. Non-uniform quantizer gives better accuracy, but the design and implementation is complicated. Okay, so that's about uniform and non-uniform quantization. Now let us understand each step involved here, step by step, and then we will be able to interpret the formulas that are going to come. Okay. So first, let me draw the boxes. Okay, so first step is sampling. The next step is quantization. So here I'll give my message signal, then this will be my sampled output, then this will be my quantized output. The quantized output can be given to an encoder, which is optional. We shall discuss that after thoroughly understanding quantization. So let me quickly label these things. This is my message signal. Message signal, and this is the analog signal. Message signal is analog signal, and here time is continuous and amplitude is also continuous, isn't it? I can show you the diagram here. If I just copy paste the diagrams here, yeah, you can see this is analog signal. It is varying in time and amplitude. Then I'll be sending this through sampling process. And then followed by quantization. This is going to be quantization. Now, if I look at the output of sampling, here time is discrete. Time is discrete. But amplitude is continuous, right? Here time is discrete and amplitude is continuous, but here both time and amplitude are discrete. After this, I can send this through an encoder or encoding process, which will encode the data for higher level of security and convenience, and it can be transmitted. Okay, so this is going to be transmitted, or TX. Right, now here, all of you please pay attention. Here the signal is X of T, that is the continuous signal. Output here is, output of sample is discrete Xn. Here again it is Xn, but here it is fully digital. This is the digital signal, output of quantizer, right? So this analog signal is given as the input to the sampling circuit. Then this is the output of sampler, right? Which is having discrete time, but amplitude is continuous. And then that is given to quantizer, which will produce discrete time, discrete amplitude waveform like this. Okay, so, and this is digital in nature, right? Now to understand this in detail, and what are the problems that we may encounter in the quantization, let me consider the analog waveform. Okay, so here I have my analog signal. So let me consider my analog signal. So this is the analog signal. All of you please pay attention and listen carefully. This is the analog signal. What is the first step you will do in the analog to digital conversion? You will convert analog signal to sampled signal, isn't it? You will convert the analog signal to sampled signal. So when I say convert this into sampled signal, what you will do is you will sample at different time intervals. Say for example, I'll consider this as one of the points, and say this as one of the points, and this as one of the points, and this as one of the points, and this, and say this, and this, and this, and say this, right? So I'll draw a line like this, sample, then this is one more sample at time, this is zero, then 1, 2, 3, so on, and then one more sample, then one sample here, then one sample here, one sample here, and this is another sample. Okay, now before I proceed, let me label these things for your convenience. This blue color line is your, what is this? Analog signal. Is your analog signal, isn't it? Then this buildings, small lines are your, what are they? Sampled output. Now I should draw the quantized output. Before I draw the quantized output, let me label a few amplitude levels here. Okay, so this is say 1, this is say 0, and then this is minus 1. Okay, so 2 volts peak to peak, plus 1 on the other side and minus 1 on the other side. Okay, now here at this point, assume that amplitude level is 0.75 volt, and obviously this is how much, 1 volt. Similarly here, assume that amplitude is 0 point, this is minus, isn't it, minus 0.75 volt. okay, any doubt so far? Any doubt so far? Say yes or no. Any doubt so far? I have taken an analog signal and I have done sampling, and these are my sampled points. Okay, and I've labeled it, and I've also labeled the amplitude levels of my sampled signal. Any doubts so far? Say yes or no. Any doubt? Because next will be the quantization process. If you have any doubt here, please ask. Okay, so let me proceed to quantization. Now I have to do quantization. For quantization, assume that I'm using 2-bit quantization, right? 2-bit quantization is what I'm using. If I use 2-bit quantization, what are the binary combinations I'll be getting? What are the binary combinations I'll be getting? I'll get 00, right? I'll get 01, I'll get 10, then I'll get 11, isn't it? These are the 4 combinations I'll get for 2-bit quantizer or 2-bit quantization. So let me mark those 4 points here. Okay, so all of you please pay attention and look how I am going to mark. So there are 4 levels. Okay, so let me make mark those 4 levels here. So let me start with the minus 1. So here I'll mark this. Then I'll make a marking here at say minus 0.5 volt. Then I'll make a marking here at 0. Then I'll make another marking at say 0.5 volt. Okay, so I've made markings at minus 1, minus 0.5, and 0, and at 0.5 volt. Okay, And what I'll do is I'll associate each amplitude level with each of the binary data. So minus one, I'll assign 0, 0. Minus 0.5, I'll assign 0, 1, right? Then 0, I'll assign 1, 0. Then 0.5, I'll assign 1. Okay. I have only four levels. So I've begun with minus one, and these are the four levels. Any doubts so far? Any doubts so far? Okay. Now observe how I am going to write the quantized output. All of you, please pay attention and listen carefully. Observe how I'm going to draw the quantized output. Okay. Now assume that I've got zero. If I've got zero, what I'll do is I'll retain my signal at zero amplitude here. My signal is zero. I'll retain it here. So my staircase will be at zero, right? Next, where is my sampled signal? It is here at 0.75. But what is the maximum quantized voltage that I've considered? 0.5. So even though, all of you listen carefully, this is the next sampled point, that is at 0.75. But the maximum quantized voltage that I've considered, or the level that I've considered, is at 0.5. So even though sampled signal is at 0.75, my quantized voltage is at 0.5, right? So this will go up like this to 0.5, and it will stay at 0.5. It will not increase beyond this. Then the next checkpoint is here. The sampled signal output is 1 volt, but even for 1 volt, I have not assigned any quantized voltage or the quantized bit. So even here, instead of writing 1 volt, I'll stick to my maximum voltage of 0.5. So this will continue to stay at 0.5. Right. Next checkpoint is at 0.75. Again, 0.75 is not mentioned. The maximum value is 0.5. So again, I'll continue to be at 0.5 till my next checkpoint. Where is my next checkpoint? My next checkpoint is here at zero. Now at zero, I know my quantized output is zero. So at this point, I'll come down. At this point, I'll come down, and then I'll continue signal. The next sample signal is here, that is at minus 0.75, but minus 0.75 voltage is not there in the quantized level. What is the nearest quantized level? It is minus 0.5. Minus 0.75 is not there in the quantized voltage. The nearest is minus 0.5. So what I'll do, I'll come down, and then I'll continue to stay at 0.5 like this. I'll continue to stay at, I will come down and I'll continue to stay at 0.5 like this, at 0.5 level, right? Then the next checkpoint is here, that is minus one, and minus one we have assigned minus 1 volt, isn't it? Minus one is assigned with minus 1 volt. So my signal will come down like this, and then it will remain at minus one till the next checkpoint, that is the next sample value. So the next sample value is how much? Minus 0.7, nearer to 0.5. So this will go down to 0.5 like this, 0.5 like this, right? And then the next checkpoint is at zero. So next checkpoint, till next checkpoint, it'll stay at 0.5. Till next checkpoint, it'll stay at 0.5, and then it'll go to zero, and then it'll stay at zero. Okay. Now this waveform is your quantized output. This waveform is your quantized output. Okay. Is this clear? Should I explain this again?
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yes.
Sir, you didn't go till positive one, but you did went till minus one. I didn't know why, sir.
Yes. See, here I have considered 2-bit quantizer. If it is a 2-bit quantizer, how many levels will I get? How many combinations will I get? 4, right? Yes or no?
Yeah.
So I've deliberately began with minus 1, okay, to help you understand what is the impact of considering lower quantization level. See here, I've considered only 4 levels, thus I'm not able to cover this maximum value. Isn't it? Now you can also say that, sir, can I shift this to positive side? Yes, you can shift. Even then there will be some error. Or you can also ignore 0 and you can push this to minus 1, minus 0.5, plus 0.5 and 1. Even then 0 will not be represented. Yes or no? You will be missing some check points, some sample points, isn't it? That is the point that I want to convey here. The bit size considered is 2 volts. And I've considered 4 levels starting from minus 1. There is no rule that you have to consider from minus 1 itself. You can also start with minus 0.5 and you can go up. Irrespective of whether you start with minus 1 or start with minus 0.5, there will be deviation. There will be quantization error. That is what I'm trying to convey. Okay.
All right, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. So let me quickly repeat on how to draw this quantized output. If somebody did not pay attention, please pay attention and listen carefully. How to draw this quantized output. Yeah. So first step is analog signal. I have taken the analog signal. Then these are my sampled outputs. You can see my sampled outputs are at 0 volt, 0.75 volt, 1 volt, 0.75 volt, 0 volt, minus 0.75, minus 1, minus 0.75 and 0 volt. Now I need to perform quantization. So what I've done is I've considered a 2-bit quantizer. A 2-bit quantizer has how many levels? 4 levels. Began with minus 1, minus 0.5, 0 and plus 0.5. These are the 4 voltage levels I've considered and these are the corresponding codes associated with these voltage levels. Now I need to draw the quantized output. So what will I do? First, I'll look at the sampled output, first sampled output. Where is my first sampled output? It is at 0, right? So what I'll do, I'll draw a line. I'll draw a line. Okay, so I'll draw a line here at 0 till the next checkpoint. Where is my next checkpoint? My next checkpoint is my next sampled output here. But here my sampled output is at plus 0.75, but the maximum quantized voltage that I've considered is 0.5. So I cannot go beyond this. So what I'll do is I'll continue to retain at 0.5 volt. Then the next checkpoint is at 1 volt. Again, 1 volt is not considered here. So I'll continue to stay at 0.5. The next checkpoint is at 0.75. Again, 0.75 is not there. The maximum value is 0.5. So I'll continue to stay at 0.5 till the next checkpoint. Where is the next checkpoint? It is at 0. At 0, we know that we have 0 volt. So here I'll come down. I'll come down and I'll stay at 0 volt till the next checkpoint. Where is the next checkpoint? It is here at minus 0.75. Minus 0.75 is approximately equal to 0.5. So I'll come down here and I'll represent it by minus 0.5. The next checkpoint is at minus 1, but we have minus 1 representation here. So I'll go down here and I'll represent this as minus 1. The next checkpoint is at 0.75. I've approximated 0.75 to be equal to 0.5. So here I'll come down to 0.5. And I'll retain 0.5 till the next checkpoint, that is here 0. Then at 0, this will become 0. Right? So this is the quantized output. Quantized output. Here, there are few important parameters that I want all of you to pay attention to. And we shall also compare the same here. Okay. So first is, say, sampled output. let me call it as S, sampled output. All of you, look at the output. Where is the first sampled output? Please comment in the chat box. Where is the first sampled output? It is at 0 volt. The first sampled output is at 0 volt, right? Where is the next sampled output? It is at 0.75, right? The next sampled output is at 1, right? Next sampled output is at 0.75. Next sampled output is at 0. Next is at -0.75. Next is at -1. Next is at -0.75. -0.75. And then next is at 0. Okay. Any doubts here? So what I've done is, whatever I've marked here, I've written here. See, 0, then this is 0.75, this is 1, this is 0.75, then this is 0, this is -0.75, this is -1, then this is 0.75, -0.75, and this is 0. Is this clear? Any doubts? Next. Right. This is the sampled output. Now let me write the quantized output. This is interesting. All of you please pay attention and listen carefully. At zero, sampled zero, what is my quantized output amplitude? It is 0, right? At sampled output of 0.75, what is my quantized output? Can someone tell me in the chat box? Please comment. It is 0.75. Very good. Then at 1, what is my quantized output? At 1, at sample output of 1, what is my quantized output? Again, it is 0.5. At 0.75, what is my quantized output? Again, it is 0.5. At 0, sample output, what is my quantized output? At 0, sample output, what is my quantized output? It is 0. Very good. At -0.75, what is my quantized output? At -0.75, what is my quantized output? It is -0.5. Very good. At -1, what is my quantized output? At -1, what is my quantized output? It is -1. Very good. And at -0.75, it is -0.5. And at 0, it is 0. Right? So this is the quantized output. Now let us write the digital output for the same. What will be the digital output? So tell me, what is the digital output I should be sending here? 0, 0, what should be the digital output? It is there in the left hand side. Please comment. If 0 is the voltage, what is the digital output? It is 1, 0. Very good. If 0.5 is the quantized output, if 0.5, that is +0.5, is the quantized output, what is the digital output? It is 1, 1. You can see here, 0.5 is 1, 1. Then again 0.5, it is 1, 1. Again 0.5 is the quantized output and its digital output is 1, 1. Quantized output is 0. For quantized output 0, digital output is 1, 0, right? For quantized output -0.5, what is the digital output? For quantized output -0.5, what is the digital output? It is 0, 1. Very good. And for quantized output -1, what is the digital output? It is 0, 0. Very good. All of you are very fast. And for -0.5 quantized output, what is the digital output? It is 0. Can you hear me? Sorry, there was some internet glitch, I think. Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me proceed. I'll finish this in next 1 minute. I hope all of you are now able to write the digital outputs. Yes. Now, quantized error is the difference between sampled output and quantized output. So here 0 minus 0 is 0, right? Then next, what is the quantized output here? Please comment in the chat box. What is the quantized output? 0.75 minus 0.5 is how much? 0.25. Similarly, what is the next quantized output? What is the next quantized output? It is 0.5. The next quantized output is 0.25. Next quantized output is 0. Next quantized output is 0 minus 0.25. Next quantized output is 0. Next quantized output is 0.25. And the next quantized error is 0. Okay. Now, all of you please pay attention to the quantized error. The reason why we have got this quantized error, ideally the quantized error should be all zeros, ideally. But we have got quantized error because the number of bits that we have used here is only 2-bit. Instead of using 2-bit for representing sample signal in terms of quantization, if I use 3-bit, what will happen to the quantization error? Can someone comment in the chat box? Instead of using 2-bit, if I use 3-bit representation, I'll get 8 combinations. What will be the impact on quantization error? Will it increase or decrease? Quantization error, will it increase or decrease? Quantization error, will it increase or decrease? Yes. Can you hear me? Quantization error will decrease if I go for 3-bit or more than 3-bit. Okay, so let me conclude. I know you have next class. So if I use 2-bits, you can see this is another way they have represented minus 1, 0.5, minus 0.5, plus 0.5, and 1, and they have omitted 0. Even this will lead to quantization error. The next method to overcome or reduce quantization error is to go for 3-bit. If you go for 3-bit, you will have many steps and this will reduce the quantization error. You can see this is the original signal and this is the quantized error. If you have more quantization bit, the quantization error decreases. So this is the quantization process. Analog signal is taken, then we do sampling, and then we do quantization. The output of the analog signal is continuous in time and amplitude. Sampling signal is discrete in time but continuous in amplitude. Quantized signal is discrete in time and amplitude. It is like a staircase signal, and this is commonly used in PCM encoder. Analog signal, you can see sampling and then quantizer. After this, we can also perform encoding and then we can transmit this signal. Okay, so that is about the process of sampling and quantization. Okay, so that's it in today's session. We shall discuss more about this in the next class. Thank you for joining me in this session. You can kindly exit this Google Meet and join the next class. Thank you. If there are any doubts, you can ask me in the next class. Okay, thank you.